Chapter 55. Drifting into the realm of dreams, Adelmo found himself in a state of disorientation as he regained consciousness, his surroundings unfamiliar and hazy. The last thing he remembered was the terrifying encounter with the shadowy figure in the cave, the memory still fresh in his mind as he tried to make sense of his current situation. As he struggled to piece together the events that led him to the hospital, Adelmo's mind raced with questions and confusion. The image of the menacing shadow looming over him replayed in his mind, sending shivers down his spine as he tried to shake off the fear that gripped him during the encounter. With a pounding headache and a sense of unease lingering, Adelmo's thoughts were clouded with uncertainty. The hospital room felt foreign to him, the beeping of machines and the sterile smell adding to his sense of disorientation. As he tried to recall the details of what happened in the cave, the memory of the shadowy figure and the impending danger it posed haunted him, leaving him with a lingering sense of dread. Day 12. Adelmo slowly rose from his bed, his head spinning as he tried to make sense of his surroundings. The room was filled with a nurse, Lana, and Nick, all looking at him with varying degrees of concern. The nurse's voice cut through the haze in his mind, informing him of the blood he had lost from the wound on his arm. Adelmo's heart raced as he struggled to differentiate between reality and the fragments of dreams that lingered in his memory. He attempted to piece together the events that led to his current state, the details slipping through his fingers like sand. The nurse, after delivering her message, turned her attention to Adelmo's vitals, checking to ensure that his body was functioning as it should. A sense of relief washed over him as the nurse confirmed that everything seemed to be back to normal. With a reassuring smile, she excused herself from the room to consult with the medical team on the next steps for Adelmo's care. Left alone with his thoughts, Adelmo's gaze shifted to Lana, who had moved closer to him with a worried expression etched on her face. Lana's eyes bore into Adelmo's, filled with a mix of fear and relief at seeing him awake. She leaned in closer, her voice soft as she asked him if he was all right. Adelmo could sense the genuine concern in her words, and it brought a sense of comfort to his troubled mind. As he tried to respond, the events of the day flooded back to him in a rush, the pain in his arm a stark reminder of the danger he had faced. With Lana by his side, Adelmo felt a glimmer of hope that he would soon be able to put this ordeal behind him and move forward. Adelmo's voice trembled as he spoke, his eyes filled with a mix of confusion and disbelief. "I can't even begin to explain everything that happened during my trip. Some of it felt so surreal, like it could only exist in a dream." He paused, trying to gather his thoughts. "The things I experienced on the plane, unless you were there, you would think I'm crazy." Lana's eyes softened with understanding as she reassured him. "I would never think you were crazy, no matter how strange it sounded. You know that, right?" Adelmo nodded, a grateful smile forming on his face. "I do know, and I can't thank you enough for believing in me. I'm truly lucky to have friends like you." Lana's empathy overflowed as she leaned in and embraced Adelmo, whispering softly in his ear, "We all love you here, and we don't want anything to happen to you." Adelmo's heart swelled with gratitude at Lana's words. Her compassion was like a soothing balm, easing his worries and fears. As Lana pulled away, Nick approached Adelmo, curiosity evident in his eyes. He wanted to know what had transpired on the plane, eager to unravel the mystery that had left Adelmo so shaken. Adelmo recounted the unbelievable events that took place, mentioning the presence of a werewolf on board attacking people. He expressed his disbelief, acknowledging that it was a difficult story to accept. However, he also shared a fascinating detail about his family history. According to him, their bloodline possessed a unique trait that made them immune to transformations into werewolves. This revelation added an intriguing layer to the narrative, hinting at a deeper connection between Adelmo and the supernatural world. As Adelmo delved deeper into his story, he touched upon the existence of vampires and other abominations in the world. He explained that his family's rare gift extended beyond protection from werewolves, encompassing a shield against various other supernatural threats. This revelation shed light on the dangers lurking in the shadows and the constant vigilance required to navigate such a perilous world. Adelmo's words painted a vivid picture of a reality where mythical creatures coexisted with humans, posing a constant threat to their safety. Meanwhile, Lana listened intently to Adelmo's tale, her expression betraying a mix of concern and admiration. She realized that the person she harbored strong feelings for belonged to a family that faced danger on a daily basis to protect others. Despite her worries for his safety, Lana found solace in the knowledge that Adelmo's unique heritage explained the sense of security she felt in his presence. This revelation deepened the bond between them, intertwining their fates in a world where supernatural forces lurked in the shadows, waiting to strike. Nick reflected on the moment when Adelmo confided in him about the strange occurrences before his trip. He recalled how Adelmo had urged him to keep an open mind, which now made sense in light of recent events. Nick knew that sharing this with his colleagues at the office would only invite skepticism and judgment, so he decided to keep it to himself and let them come to their own conclusions. Adelmo, on the other hand, expressed his relief at Nick's understanding and support. He acknowledged the risk he took in revealing the unusual circumstances to Nick, fearing that he would be labeled as crazy and ostracized. Adelmo appreciated the reassurance from Lana and Nick, knowing that they valued his friendship and loyalty enough to stand by him, even in the face of uncertainty. Lana chimed in, emphasizing the importance of loyalty and trust in their friendship with Adelmo. She reassured him that they would never turn their backs on him, especially considering the unwavering support he had shown them in the past. Nick echoed Lana's sentiments, expressing his gratitude for Adelmo's honesty and acknowledging the bond of trust that held their group together. Adelmo, touched by their words, thanked them both for their understanding and support.